In this video, we will talk about atrioventricular blocks. Atrioventricular blocks, also called heart blocks, refer to the conduction disorders between the atria and ventricles. They may occur at the level of the atrioventricular node or the bundle of His. First-degree atrioventricular block is characterized by prolonged PR intervals. In first-degree atrioventricular block, the PR interval is greater than 200 milliseconds. On this ECG, the PR interval is 240 milliseconds. Prolongation of the PR interval to 300 milliseconds or more is called a marked first-degree atrioventricular block. This can lead to pseudopacemaker syndrome, which is characterized by significant asynchrony between atrial and ventricular contractions, resulting in retrograde blood ejection from the atria. This ECG shows an extremely prolonged PR interval of 440 milliseconds. The P waves merge with the T waves of the previous complex. The PR interval on this ECG is 640 milliseconds. Type 1, also called Mobitz 1, second-degree atrioventricular block is characterized by progressive prolongation of the PR interval, which results in a non-conducted P wave, a dropped QRS complex. The main clue is that the PR interval after the non-conducted P wave is shorter than the PR interval before it. Usually, the PR interval after the non-conducted P wave is shortest, and the PR interval before the non-conducted P wave is longest. This is called the Winckelbach phenomenon. Sometimes, a constant, repeating conduction ratio is seen in Mobitz 1. On this ECG, there is a constant conduction ratio of 3 to 2. Sometimes the P waves may completely merge with the T waves. This makes them difficult to find. The PR interval after a non-conducted P wave is shorter than the PR interval before a non-conducted P wave, which indicates Mobitz 1 second-degree atrioventricular block. Occasionally, atrioventricular block with a 2-to-1 conduction ratio is seen, accompanied by the occasional conduction of two consecutive P waves. If PR interval prolongation is observed, Mobitz 1 is the cause of the 2-to-1 conduction ratio. If the cycles are short enough, it's easy to see that the RR interval becomes progressively shorter with each beat of the cycle. However, the last RR interval in the cycle following a non-conducted P wave may be slightly longer. Mobitz 2 second-degree atrioventricular block is characterized by intermittent non-conducted P waves without progressive prolongation of the PR interval. The PR intervals are constant. Only a quarter of patients with Mobitz 2 second-degree atrioventricular block have narrow QRS complexes. Usually, wide QRS complexes are seen. Type 2-to-1 is a distinct type of second-degree atrioventricular block. In this type, every other P wave is non-conducted. Sometimes the P wave may be completely superimposed on the T wave of the previous beat. P waves may sometimes be completely invisible due to superimposition with T waves. This ECG may be misinterpreted as sinus bradycardia. However, a careful examination of the long strip may provide a clue to the diagnosis. A high-grade second-degree atrioventricular block is characterized by a fixed P-QRS ratio, 3-to-1, 4-to-1, etc. This ECG shows a ventricular rate of 27 beats per minute and constant PR intervals. Every third P wave is conducted. Complete atrioventricular block, also called third degree, is characterized by an absence of atrioventricular conduction, resulting in atrioventricular dissociation and independent atrial and ventricular rhythms. None of the supraventricular impulses are conducted to the ventricles. Either escape junctional rhythm or ventricular standstill may be present. Narrow QRS complexes of junctional origin indicate proximal atrioventricular block, which occurs at the level of the AV node. Wide QRS complexes of ventricular origin suggest a distal block, which occurs below the AV node, i.e., the bundle of His or bundle branches. If no escape rhythm occurs during complete atrioventricular block, ventricular standstill and ventricular asystole will result. This ECG strip shows complete atrioventricular block leading to ventricular standstill. The first two QRS complexes are of sinus origin, with normal PR intervals preceding them. Six P waves after the second QRS complex are not conducted. There is a pause of 5.6 seconds. The last QRS complex is of junctional origin. It is one of the most life-threatening rhythm abnormalities. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe.